Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers of Cricket Happenings. This is your host, Ram, welcoming you to this Tuesday edition of the Cricket Happenings by telling you that India, with their third straight win in this Asia Cup, has already booked a place into the finals of the Asia Cup. So now tomorrow is going to be the battle, which is because Sri Lanka are virtually out of the competition now. And now it depends on tomorrow's match is going to be crucial, as both the teams are going to be fighting it out, Pakistan versus Bangladesh, which I'll be definitely doing a brief preview on this Cricket Happening show of mine. And tomorrow, and today was the seventh match between India versus Sri Lanka, and well, India proved too strong for Sri Lanka here. So just talking about this particular match, this was the seventh match of the Asia Cup, which was played here in Mirpur, and India won the toss. And India decided that they will insert the Sri Lankans into bat first. As you would know, in that a shock defeat that happened, if I'm not wrong, it was India who batted first, if my memory serves me right. But here, India decided to insert the Lankans. And well, I can say that it was some very tight bowling from both India's pace bowlers, Ashish Nehra and Jasprit Bumrah, giving nothing away and really making the batsmen work for the runs. And then finally, it was the wicket of Dinesh Chandimal, which was taken by Ashish Nehra, bowling a very good line, a testing line, as he got the ball to actually move away from Chandimal, and Dhoni behind the stumps took the catch. So he was the first wicket to go. Now, Dinesh Chandimal was scalped for four, and after that, Shahan Jayasurya came to the crease, along with Dilshan, the experienced person at the crease. But then it was Jasprit Bumrah actually bowling a very good ball, a good length delivery, and Shahan Jayasurya even didn't wait for the umpire's decision as he left, as he was caught behind by Dhoni. There was no appeal from either Bumrah or Dhoni, and Shahan Jayasurya was absolutely walking up as he knew that he had nicked it, and he was gone for three, and Sri Lanka were in trouble at 15 for two. And when Kapagadra joined Tilkarunai Dilshan. Dilshan, well, he definitely didn't look his old self. Contributed 18 of 16 deliveries with two fours before it was Pandya who actually got Dilshan into a real bind, made him, bowled a bouncer to him first up. The very first delivery that he was bowling in this particular Sri Lankan innings, he bowled a bouncer and forced Dilshan to have a hook at it. And Dilshan hooked. And it was Ashwin who took the catch, and Dilshan was gone for 18 of 16 balls with 2 fours. So that made it 31 for 3. And then it was Angelo Matthews walking in to join Chamara Kapagadra. Well, Angelo Matthews could not do much. It was Hardik Pandya who once again showing what a utility person he is by actually rattling the stumps of Angelo Matthews for 18 of 19 balls with 3 fours. After that, it was Kapagadra who was holding the fort for the Lankans, as Milinda Srivardhana left by Milinda Srivardhana was dismissed by Ravichandran Ashwin. Raina taking a good catch, 20 of 17 balls with 1-4 and 1-6. And then Shanaka, who probably could have played a good role here under the circumstances, perished in the 17th over, run out for 1, which made it 104 for 6. And then Kapagadra, after putting quite 30 of 32 balls, as he was seeing that he was trying to hold the fort there. But then Jasprit Bumrah actually picked up his wicket, getting him caught by Pandya for 30 of 32 balls with 3 fours. And then it was only the big hitting, in the sense of from 105 for 7 in the 18th over, if at all Sri Lanka managed to reach 138 for 9, it was only due to some good hitting done by both the all-rounders. Tisra Pereira contributing 17 of 6 deliveries with 2 fours and 1 six, and Kulashekara pasting 13 of 9 balls with 2 fours. But Tisra Pereira was stumped behind the wicket by Dhoni of the bowling of Ashwin for 17 of 6 balls, and Kulashekara was run out for 13, and Shamira was not out on 2, and Sri Lanka innings ended at 138 for 9 of the 20 overs. The bowling, as I said, was absolutely on the mark. Jasprit Bumrah and Ashish Nehra doing a very good job first up. Ashish Nehra 4 overs, 1 for 23. Bumrah a bit costly to his standards today. 4 overs no made in 227. Hardik Pandya, as I said, really increasing his utility value to the team every time he's there. 4 overs no made in 2 for 26. Yuvraj Singh bowled 1 over for 3 runs. Jadeja, 2 overs went for 19. It was a bit costly today. Ashwin gave away 26 runs in his full quota of 4 overs with 2 wickets, and Suresh Raina bowled 1 over for 9 runs. And then it was the turn for India to chase 138. And especially considering that the Mirpur pitch, we have seen low scores. It was not something that India could have taken for granted. And definitely, India didn't have a good start. First, it was the once again the pace bowlers really showing their showing that how this pitch is really helping them. As first Shikhar Dhawan was sent back to the pavilion. That was the breakthrough that Sri Lanka got by picking up Shikhar Dhawan pretty early in the piece. Caught behind by Chandim Mal for one. So that was the first wicket, number one, which made it 11 for one in the second over. And then Rohit Sharma followed, caught by Kapugadra of the bowling of Kulashekara for 15, or 14 balls with 3 fours, which made it 16 for 2. And then it definitely required somebody to stay at the wicket, and that came in the form of Suresh Raina along with the in-form Virat Kohli, and both slowly started working their way around. And once they did that, they put on a 54 run partnership for the third wicket, with Suresh Raina contributing 25 of 26 balls with 2 fours. But Virat Kohli was looking his pristine self as he was stroking the ball neatly and sweetly. And then Suresh Raina was dismissed by Dasun Shaka for 25 of 26 balls. So we hit 74-3, which brought Yuvraj Singh to the crease. And Yuvraj Singh, for the first time in this particular Asia Cup, I thought playing with a lot, even though he did a good job against Pakistan, I thought today he definitely showed the Yuvraj Singh of old, as he clattered 3 fours and 3 sixes in a knock of 35, an enterprising knock of 35 of just 18 deliveries with 3 fours and 3 sixes. It was pretty good to see. Virat Kohli was staying there at the wicket, but allowing Yuvraj Singh to really take over. And Yuvraj Singh really played a very good role. He clubbed a few 3 sixes and 3 boundaries in a knock of 35. It was very impressive. And then Tisra Pereira actually picked up his wicket, but not before another very quick partnership that happened between Yuvraj Singh and Virat Kohli, out of which Yuvraj Singh was the one who had done the majority of the scoring. So that really, it was a 51 run partnership which came in pretty quick time. In 5 overs, they put on 50 runs, which was good to see. And after that, Hardik Pandya came in, but Hardik Pandya was cleaned up by Rangana Herath as he clean bowled him for 2. And then finally, Dhoni was the one who really completed the formalities. He remained not out on 7 or 4 balls with 1 6. At the other end, Virat Kohli had got to his third consecutive 50, one could say, as he reeled off another 50 today, with an unbeaten 56 to his name of 47 deliveries with 7 fours, and India were home in the 20th over. So a 5 wicket victory registered by India. And as I said, India now definitely have almost booked up. I mean, they already booked a place into the finals of the Asia Cup. They only have one engagement left, and that is to take on the Minos United Arab Emirates. Well, as far as the bowling was concerned, Angelo Matthews 3 overs, went for 16. Kulashekara bowled well, 3 overs, 221. Chisra Pereira, 4 overs, 132. Chamira could not get a handle on the Indian batsman today. 4 overs, 27 runs and no wicket. Rangana Herath was very costly. In fact, it was Yuvraj Singh going after him. 3.2 overs, no made in 1 for 26. 1 over for 7 for Dasun Shaka. And Milind Srivardhana, 1 over for 13. So Virat Kohli took away the Man of the Match award for the second consecutive time here. So that is as far as, this is the third consecutive time, I would say, in the Asia Cup that Virat Kohli has taken the Man of the Match. So that is as far as that match is concerned. So India definitely sailing smoothly, and they have already lived up to the expectations of being into the